Hey everybody, welcome to the Jamie Shaw Marketing Show. And how's everybody doing tonight? Tonight, my good friend WonderWhit is here with us, and it's Instagram gone wild. She's going to talk about Instagram. She's going to show us how she blew up her Instagram account. We're getting many followers. So you want to jump on and say hi, WonderWhit?
Am I muted or can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, cool. No, I'm good. Hi. I'm gonna do this. We're gonna show you how to grow your Instagram following. There's a lot of different ways you can do it, so I'm gonna show you a few ways I went. I actually went from 300 when I started the strategy. Sorry, that's my daughter. When I started my strategy, and then I went to 10,000 followers inside of 3 months. And right now, that account is sitting at 11.7, and I have a second account that went 6,000 followers in 6 weeks, and it's currently sitting at like 7,800, I think. So there's credibility to this method, but I have a cold. And I'm a little, my throat gets dried out, so I have to, if I start coughing, I apologize. But let me take this.
How many of you know WonderWhit, mama of three kids? So she's busy all the time.
Sorry. I know my daughter is over here yelling at me to get some water, and she's trying to drink my. It's throat tea, and I don't want her to drink it. It's not for kids, so yeah, I had to get up and get her water. But is there anything you wanted me to start with first, Jamie?
It's your platform. You teach it how you want to teach it.
Jamie's giving me the controls, guys.
I see Joe in the chat. Hi, Joe. How you doing?
Joe. Okay, well, let me go ahead and.
I'm gonna meet up and take notes. If you got need me for anything, just holler.
Okay, well, let me go ahead and share my screen then. Oh, if I can push the button. Here we go. So here's the first account. Let me pull up the second one just so. No. Okay. So I have two different accounts, and one is a business account, one is my personal account. This is my personal account. It was the first one I went ahead and started my strategy with. The thing about Instagram is it's kind of like having a magazine. Like, your account on Instagram is basically a magazine for people to flip through or scroll through and, kind of comment on what they like and engage with things that they like. This account, I have targeted my account. So I'm not marketing to everyone. I don't want to appeal to everyone because I don't want to work with everyone, quite frankly. I want to work with specific individuals. This account is tailored more to the mom lifestyle and more to, families and mompreneurs and that sort of thing. So right here, you'll start to see this is a newer post. I have more pictures of myself, kids, just kind of everyday life. I do have like a format. I usually have my things in like threes or fours. So what I mean by that is I have kind of like a specific tailoring. I have my kid posts. I have my mom stuff that I do. I'm kind of a foodie. I really, really love food. I don't think I really know anybody who doesn't love food. That's probably somebody you wouldn't want to trust. I'm just saying, you might want to question them if they don't love food. some hill country living out here. I live in Texas, so I get to see a lot of beautiful scenery. I live in the hill country and not in the city. So this is all stuff that I include because this allows my audience to kind of get to know me. They see me with my selfies that I include on here. I really try to get shots where you can see my eyes. I don't do like looking away stuff, or I try not to like heavily filter my pictures of myself, because it's a psychological thing. People kind of impose when they can see your eyes and they derive a meaning from it. So you won't find a lot of pictures of me with like sunglasses or anything like that, mostly because I wear glasses already. But these are things that are important to me. I use my platform very specifically. You want to be specific in the way that you are trying to appeal to people. This is my vision board in the background. It's a selfie with my vision board. 13 comments and 259 likes. That's kind of ridiculous. It's just a selfie, guys. And it's a selfie with a vision board. But because I'm targeting people who are interested in that sort of thing, they respond. And I'm going to pull this up again. What you see, the hashtags. Now, I'm big on hashtags. I'll use anywhere from 10 to 20 hashtags on one photo, because you're targeting your audience that way. These hashtags go into the millions on Instagram. They have millions of daily uses on Instagram. So the higher the rank of the hashtag, the wider chance, or the better chance, that you're going to have that somebody is going to search that hashtag. So I'm going to show you really quick up here. Let's say you are, hold on, you know what? Let me go to the other account. The other account is more tailored to entrepreneurs, boss lady lifestyle, a little more aggressive alpha females. I don't have any pictures of my kids on here, even though it says I am a mom. Definitely has that on there. That is a part of my life. I don't try to hide that, obviously. But this is tailored to the marketing consulting that I do, motivational coach, mountain mover. I want this to be more of a powerful vibe that they're getting. And it's very specific. My layout set that I use is three quotes and then a selfie. And again, I'm targeting where you can see my eyes in the photo. I'm very particular about these selfies. And then all these quotes are things that I really vibe with. It's very, very specific. I mean, look at this, 138, 103, 66, 86, 94. I mean, these are pretty good engagements. I mean, most people on their private accounts, and this is a business account, so I'm able to boost these posts. However, I have not boosted any posts on Instagram. So these are just organic likes and engagement. I'm not doing follow for follow or anything like that. Like 138 on this one with Tony Robbins. Let's pull this up. I didn't even tag this. Holy crap. I'm sorry. I thought I tagged this one. I didn't even hashtag anything on here. I just posted it. That's kind of crazy. 138 completely organic likes. That's bananas. Let's go over here. So, okay, like I said, this is more marketing towards the alpha female. You've got mompreneur, boss lady, boss babe, entrepreneur, dedication, rise and grind, grind, vibes, dedication. Okay, you can read. But you can see that the kind of engagement this stuff gets. These are just showing you different hashtags that I'm using. I'm going to go back, and now I'm going to show you how to search them. On here, on a laptop, you can't narrow down the search by hashtag, so it may or may not pull up some inappropriate nature. I cannot guarantee. I'm going to try to hopefully not pull that up. So let's start with mentor. It'll pull up people's pages, but what I want to look for specifically is the hashtag right here. The hashtag mentor has over 1 million posts. These are all people who are interested in mentoring in some way, shape, or form. Either they want one or they want to be one. These are the people that I particularly am looking for, because I want to build leaders. And if you're already on a path to leadership, that's even better. Let me figure out how I can help you. That's what you want to think about when you're using hashtags. The mistake that most people make with hashtagging is they try to make their own. Now, there's nothing wrong with making your own, but you're going to want to drive some traffic to that hashtag. So use something that's already ranking. Think of hashtags like keywords. Let's go to mindset. Oh, whoops. Spell it right. We're going to go to the hashtag mindset if I can find it. See, this is what I don't like about the computer version of... Did I pass it? Yes, I did. Over 3 million posts on mindset. I definitely vibe with anybody who gets that mindset matters. Absolutely, it does. Let's go... You want to get even more broad. Let's go with motivation. This is again, I cannot say that nothing will come up when we pull this up, but I mean, 88 million posts. Every social media platform is becoming a search engine of its own. So think of Instagram like its own little version of Google or Facebook. They all have hashtags to help rank all these key, and hashtags are just like keywords. So pull up motivation. Let's see who's posting about what. Now, you're probably going to get a lot of gym stuff, entrepreneur stuff, modeling. But these are people you want to do business with because they're dedicated. Yes, you have school tomorrow, honey. Stop rosy. Okay, where are we at? We're on motivation. Look, this person has limited engagement, even though they have a ton of hashtags. Why? Because she just posted 37 seconds ago. So give that some time, and I bet, because all her hashtags are pretty much on point, she'll have some engagement in no time. A lot of these guys are personal trainers. They're fitness athletes looking for sponsors. Let's go up here. Let's go back to entrepreneur. Rosie, please stop. Okay, so these are people who are already in the space looking for like minds. Sorry, my throat's going out. Hold on. Okay. Now, there's two ways to rank on when you search for a hashtag. One is going to be top posts, so like the posts that are getting the most likes and engagement. You can see this one's got over 2,000 likes. Then only 16 comments. It's kind of surprising. As you saw, some of mine had 200 likes and like 13 comments. So, I mean, these are just, wait, what hashtags is he using? Entrepreneurship, startup, startup mentor, entrepreneur, entrepreneur motivation, mentor, founders. So these are good hashtags that they're ranking. excuse me.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm dying a little bit. It's okay. I'll live through. And then you have most recent. This is another way to rank on hashtagging with Instagram. So these are the people who have posted like within the last couple seconds. Obviously, the further down you scroll, the further down you scroll, the longer time has passed. But yeah, these are all within a few seconds. So let's go here. See, 2 minutes. But these are, I mean, look at people's hashtags, especially the ones who are ranking. Granted, the ones who are ranking most probably have a good amount of followers, but this is how they get those followers. Excuse me. Okay, let me go back to, let me show you some other hashtags, especially in our So let's go to dedication. 16 million. These can be tailored too. Let's show how to do that. So if you're like in health and wellness MLMs, you can go health. 22 million hashtags. That's ridiculous. Just by searching health. Now you go here, like for women, particularly women in health and wellness, girl to lift. 13 million. This is for women who like to lift weights in the gym. Let's see. If you're a guy, guys who lift. This is how you find people. If you're in a health and wellness MLM, you know, search like gym. Simple word. 86 million. 86 million uses. And another thing you can do when you find this is you can go like 34,000 likes. This person is obviously ranking. Come on, open up. Let's go to visit his profile. 1.4 million followers. If you really want to get targeted on who's following you, this is what you do. You come in here and you start following their followers, because statistically, more than half of them are going to follow you back. You can start and you can just follow. Instagram will tell you time out when you've hit too many, give it a break. You know, let it rest for a couple hours, come back to it, see if you can follow again. But like, I mean, this guy's obviously put a lot of work into his profile. He's got a specific layout with these borders. These white borders is an app feature that a lot of people use because it makes it look more neat inside here, less cluttered. I personally don't care about that, so I don't have time for that. I'm not going to invest a lot of time on borders. That's ridiculous. But, you know, if you have the time, go for it. Okay, so that's another way you can target your following is by following specific people. If you're in an MLM, I would suggest not following anybody inside your MLM. And that's not to say like, oh, what's mine is mine, or, you know, whatever. It's because if you have like, you know, top earners inside your MLM and you go through and you try to follow their followers, typically you're going to follow a lot of people already inside of your MLM. So if you're in a health and wellness MLM, I would suggest starting to look at people who are in fitness magazines. You know, celebrities who are known for really fit bodies. That's a way to do it too. Now, if you are a network marketer in general, and you're just into network marketing, and you're looking to coach some people or set them up with your system, you're looking for people who are business minded, go follow. Let's go look at Ty Lopez. This is his official account. 1.7 million followers. Go follow his followers. He's got plenty of followers. You know for certain he is not consulting every one of these people one-on-one. There's just no way he has that kind of time. So go follow his... Oh, I started following him. Go follow his followers. These are people who are interested in Ty Lopez and what he has to say. Look, you can come on here. Let's look up Eric Worre. Ta-da! He's just under 100,000. Look at this picture. This is hilarious. I vibe so hard with this. He's in shorts. That's awesome. Sorry. I'm laughing probably more than that's funny, but oh well. Anyway, you can go through... Thank you. I'm getting kisses. Okay, so you can go through and follow their followers, and that's how you can generate a specific following. People who are interested in what you have to say, not just by hashtags. Cross them. Use both methods. Now, on Instagram, you can follow, I think it's 7,500 people, and then you got to dial it back. So go through and start unfollowing people after that. And it really doesn't matter if, it really doesn't matter if they're following you or not. Just go unfollow them. That way you can get your count down and you can expand so you can follow more people. Now, I would say do that probably like 1,000 at a time just so you don't get slapped by Instagram, because then they're like, whoa, what are you doing? Don't unfollow everyone. You're supposed to be engaging. Now, there are automated systems that you can use so that way you don't have to spend an hour a day doing that kind of crap. That's what I do because I ain't got time. I have 3 kids. I have multiple businesses. No, I would shave my head like Britney Spears style. So these are ways you want a specific following. You don't want everybody and their mother following you because you don't want to work with everybody. That's just how it's going to come down to it. Not everybody is meant for this type of business or your type of business. Not everyone's meant for network marketing. So it's best to find the people who are already interested in that. Now for me, because I consult with a lot of MLMers and small business owners, I look for people who are top leaders in certain MLMs, and I go follow their following. I want to work with their following because their following is the one who's struggling, and that's why they're following top leaders, and I want to help those people. So that's what I do. I go follow those people, and then they come follow me back, and I have an automated system that unfollows them for me. Oh my gosh. I feel like I'm talking a lot. Jamie, you still there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay. Any questions so far? I feel like I'm going kind of fast.
Yeah, I was going to ask where you find your hashtags, but you already showed that. So when you make a post, do you post your picture, then you go in and put hashtags after you post?
Yeah. Well, because you do it while you – it's like a caption. So you do it while you post.
Okay.
I post from my phone so I can see the ranking right away. Hold on a second. Let me just show you what I mean really quick. Okay, can you see me? Okay, there I am. Oh, not my phone. Oh, good Lord. Okay. Can you guys hear my daughter?
Yeah, I can hear her. I was looking at my.
She's terrible.
I was looking at my Instagram account. And it's like I got 130 followers.
Okay, let's say that I wanted to post this picture of my daughter. Now, before I actually post it, it's going to bring up this thing. It's a little box, and you can start to type in a hashtag. Like, I'll type in girl. And it'll bring up a whole bunch of hashtags with the word girl in it. Now, just the hashtag girls, plural, has over 101 million posts. These are people who are posting pictures of their kids and hashtagging it with girls. You know, if you're using pictures of your kids, hashtag girl, kids, mom life, dad life, parenting, stuff like that. I mean, what else do I post when I post pictures of my kids? let's see, this last one that I use mom life, kids, work from home, mompreneur, moms, boys, twins, girl, monster, love, family, happy, and the day of the week. That's also a really big one because people want to see what's relevant, what's going on for that day. People will post Monday through Friday and every day of the week. It's ridiculous. But it's another way to search. It's another way people find you. Excuse me.
You got it good, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. You should have seen me yesterday. I was, like, dying. I'm pretty sure I had a pretty high fever, but I didn't want to look. I didn't want to freak out if I did have a high fever. I was like, I'm just going to take some Tylenol and try to rest. And then it was early released for my kids, so they weren't even in school.
Yeah, I got it, like, 2 weeks before Christmas. Yeah, actually, I come down with it the morning of my show on Thursday. Well, I did my show Thursday night, and I was dying. As soon as I was done, I went and crawled in bed.
Oh, man, I would have, too. But, yeah, I didn't do my live yesterday. That's another thing I've been doing on Instagram. I've been going live on my profile. I actually put it on my profile.
How do you do an Instagram live?
See, I held myself accountable and I said live Monday through Friday, 11:30 CST, which is my time, Texas time. On Instagram, the way you go live, excuse me, I'm sorry. Oh my gosh. Trying to like clear my throat. So on your phone, this is like your Instagram main page, and up here you'll see the Instagram story.
Yeah.
That you just swipe your thingy to the left, and it's going to pull up your camera. And down at the bottom left, it has this little live feature. So you don't even have to title it. We're going to go live, if my connection will let me. That's all you do is hit go live. And it starts checking your connection, which apparently mine sucks. So, whatever. Be like that. But, yeah, that's just how you just swipe left on your main screen with Instagram, and you can go live. Now, there is no replay when you go live, which it kind of works in your favor because that's another urgency factor for people to jump on your live and see what you're saying. But I have put it on my profile that I'm live daily, so my main followers jump on my lives, and I'm starting to grow a few regulars. This has only been like 2 weeks that I've been doing it, I want to say. And every once in a while, I post a story. So these stories up here, when you post up here, they come pop up on people's, and that's the way you show up. You're right there on their screen, and they're going to click because they're curious. Half the time, I click because I'm curious, and I don't even have time to wait. But, you know, that's another way people find you. You just pop up in their feed. Sometimes they follow you, and they forget about you. So you pop up in their feed and say, here I am, remember me, I'm cool. I'm that cool person you followed because you like my stuff. And then they come check out your stuff again. I have people who go through my account and like 20 pictures at a time, which kind of worries me sometimes. I'm like, hey, are you a stalker or just really bored? I'm not sure. But most of the time, I mean, it's very, I've never had like a stalker person come from Instagram. At least not that I know of yet.
And they've changed a lot since the last time I was on here.
Mm-hmm. Instagram's had a lot of updates. Instagram's no longer a timeline display either. There's an algorithm. That's another way that these hashtags work for you, because you start manipulating the algorithm in your favor to show relevant stuff in your feed and to show up in other people's feeds. So when you're using hashtags that are common interests for somebody that you're not following, you're more likely to be a suggestion in their box for them to follow. And it still pops up stuff on mine, too, where I am suggested followers and to go follow people. Oh, what? Stop it. Okay, so another thing is your direct message. This is a huge tool. It's underutilized, and for the people who are using it, it's done in the wrong way. You can have, there's tons of services out there that are free that can send a direct message for you. The best way to utilize this is to send a message to your followers, your new followers, one time. I've had messages that say, hey, this is a bot, but if you reply back, you'll get a live person. It'll be me on the other end. I just wanted to say hi and thank you for following. That's a cool message. I'm down with that because, one, right away you're acknowledging that, you know, hey, this is a bot. I want to say hi, though, and thank you. That's pretty cool. I'm okay with that. And I, most of the time I reply back, like, hey, how's it going? But when you send your message, what I do is I tell them a little bit about me. I'm like, hey, I'm WonderWhit. I'm a mom of three, and I'm a marketing consultant. If you have any questions, let me know. I look forward to getting to see your stuff on my Instagram feed. Sorry. I'm dying. And that usually gets a lot of engagement. My initial message on Instagram was, hey, I'm WonderWhit, Mama 3. Over here on Facebook, I have this group, and I post free trainings and motivational stuff, tips and tricks for people who are looking to grow their small businesses or MLM businesses. And that's how I got a lot of people. I got, I think it was like, I grew that group, I want to say about 300 to 400 people from Instagram came over to that group in just 3 months. So, I mean, about 100 people a month were coming in. That was fresh, new, warm market. Because in that group, I'm promoting myself. I'm promoting my consultation services. You can do the same thing for a health and wellness group. Like, hey, here's a group I host for, you know, more information. And the thing is, when you invite somebody to a group, you want to make sure that you're providing value and not just product pushing or spamming your link. You definitely want to be educating people. So, like, if you're, you know, in a beauty business or whatever, like a makeup business, do the tutorial videos. Show people how to. Show people the products. You don't even have to be specific. I know a lot of girls will, like, label their makeup. They'll tell you the name, color. I mean, I swear, it's almost like the batch number that it comes out of. And I'm like, nobody needs to know that. They just need to see the color and what you do with it. 9 times out of 10, they have a similar color or they want to do something similar anyway, so don't. But when you have product, use some product knowledge. If you have a shake, tell me what kind of protein you have in there and why it's so awesome. What makes it different from every other friggin' protein powder out there? If you have a supplement that's supposed to detox, tell me what does the detox, but don't tell me, hey, it's in this supplement. Tell me A, B, and C does X, Y, and Z. Don't tell me anything about the product. Let me ask you. Don't answer the question before it's asked. Don't. Don't.
When you're posting lifestyle pictures and stuff, what do you post when you have a boring lifestyle?
When you have a boring life, post your boring lifestyle. I have a pretty boring lifestyle. I mean, I have kids and I stay home all the time. I don't go out. I don't go party. I don't go, you know.
Well, my wife takes a lot of pictures of us on the bike in the summertime when we're riding, you know, so, I mean, that would be something good to post. And I just searched Harley Davidson. There's like 4.9 million posts on Harley Davidson. So
that's a passion item. You can search hashtag BJJ for Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Mm-hmm.
That's another passion industry right there. Martial arts, hashtag martial arts, MMA. There's a lot of different stuff. And I just did this because one of my clients is launching an MMA apparel line. So, so I did some hashtag research. And then one of my friends is I want to say a fighter. He does Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. He's done it for a long time. And he's a 2-time world champion. So he's trying to grow his account to, you know, get sponsorships now.
Jeez. I just searched. Search travel. 151 million posts on travel.
Oh, yeah.
Holy shit.
Think about that if you're in the travel industry. And then you have the Instagram posts. Insta-like, Insta-followers, Insta-fame, Insta-travel, you know, Insta-adventure. Oh, hashtag that for adventure. That one's a good one. I can't believe I'm telling everyone all this. Everybody's going to know all my secrets. They're not really secrets. You're welcome, by the way. If you watch this replay, you are so welcome. You have no idea.
A lot of people, I mean, I started out using it, and then I just didn't know what to post to it, so I quit using it, you know. So
post the things you love the most. Post the most. But I mean, I'm specific with my accounts. Like if you have multiple business opportunities, create separate accounts for each niche. Like I have a health and wellness MLM and I haven't done anything with it, but I intend to create a separate account for that. That way it's not tied in and all mixed together. And then you're marketing to everyone and all that. You don't want to go there. Just keep them separate. Hey, this is my fitness account. Hey, this is my travel account. This is my, you know, personal account or my business account. You know, stuff like that. That way you can keep them all separate. It's easier. I don't spend a lot of time on Instagram. The most time I spend on there is returning messages, just because that's where I want to focus. That's where I want to cultivate relationships and build rapport with people. I don't want to be posting 20 times a day. In fact, I rarely post every day. I think I post maybe 3 times a week.
Okay. Dumb question. How do I get to my my direct messages?
On your phone, it's at your top right corner, and it looks like a little paper airplane. Click on that.
Okay.
That's your inbox. Now, if you see a picture you like and you want to message that person, and this is something I heard Gary Vee say the other day, I'm going to follow up. But if you want to message that person, you just click the little 3 buttons on the picture. And it'll have your options like send a message or comment or block or whatever.
All right, cool.
So, but Gary Vee had a tip on he was getting his hair cut and he had downtime. So he's going through Instagram, right? I mean, he has to sit still. Otherwise his hair is going to get jacked. So he's going through and he was showing people how his barber could direct message people, search people. You can search. Let me see. I'm going to share this really quick. Oh, my nose. Please stop being stuffy.
I know April Marie Tucker teaches, like, she does, like, 4 or 5 posts. And she does a post with a link in it.
I don't post any links. The only link I have is this one up in my bio. I don't want people going everywhere. I want people going to where I want them to go.
Right.
And I switch this link out. Sometimes I send it to my blog. Sometimes I send it to my group or my page. Stuff like that. I switch it out. Sometimes I have it go to a capture page or funnel. My other one has it go to a capture page. But let's check out Starbucks. Oh, hey. Oh, Rosie. Stop it. Oh. So you have, okay, this is what I was looking for. Okay, right here, this is a location. Rose, please stop. You can search your local area for things around here. So here we have a local Starbucks. You can pull this up, and now you see all the pictures that were tagged there. This is a great way to find people who are local to you. If you're running, if you're a personal trainer and you want to find clients that are local to you, this is a really, 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 really great asset. You can find people. Look at all these tags. This is all at this one location. These are people who checked in here, so they're obviously local. And then you can look and see, maybe they were just traveling and they were visiting. Or if they were, you know, actually in that. Of course, I'd pick the one that's not in English. Thank you.
Yeah, when I set mine up, I couldn't figure out how to get all the emojis and crap on there. So I loaded on my desktop and went and found a thing where I could take the emojis and copy them and paste them in my profile to get it set up.
Yeah, see, I have to be on my phone. That's why I post from my phone. One, I can look up the hashtags, and two, I can use emojis if I want to grab some attention. But I'm not one of those people who has, like, a storyline. Every once in a while, I post, like, an actual caption on it, but most of the time, it's just hashtagging. But, yeah, I mean, this is another way. Like, I'm in Texas, right? So let's search. This is my closest local city. Come on. Now I can see all the content for people who have been posting in San Antonio.
Been there.
Where?
San Antonio.
Oh.
I spent 3 months there.
Lackland Air Force Base.
Yep.
Yeah, Fort Sam's here in Camp Bullis.
Then I went back there in, May of 2012 to watch my son graduate from basic.
But, like, here, okay, so if I'm looking for locals, I'm going to look for locals with my common interests. So if I see something that stands out to me, look, somebody who likes cooking, cool. I like food. This is a business account. But and then I get from here, I can go look at their account. What they're selling, what they're into. Let's go to a person. A person would be better. So, who is this? This is. Okay, I need to. Okay, this is a person. Zero likes, zero comments. Oh, come on. Why am I picking all the bad people?
The one above it was the Undertaker.
What's oh Undertaker? Where? Where am I?
I don't know where it is. It moved.
Ranking. Okay, let's look at this person. Okay, so this is somebody who's visiting. So here's somebody who likes to travel. Right? Is this a kid? Dang it, is this a kid? I am not on it today. Let's go here. That was a very tiny baby bump. They're not in English. Why can't I have so many in English? Like, food truck. I like food. The deep fryer. Like, this is a business. This is somebody I'd be interested in potentially helping. You know, if I wanted to grow their social media or possibly teach them how to market this account. 6 followers, 9 following. Hell yeah, they need my help. I'm gonna hit them up in a minute. Actually, can I? Hold on, let's see.
Yeah, you can help me. I need a lot of help.
Dang it. Okay, I can't DM from a laptop. I'm going to have to hit them up later. I'm going to show you how I would. I'm leery about hitting any of these. Here, let's go here. Look, people. Hopefully you aren't a child. Like, on the young side. Okay, so look. We've got somebody who was former band, possibly still in band. I don't know if he's in high school or not. It looks like he's in high school. Maybe let's find a different account. Why can't I find somebody like over 18? Or, you know, at least not. Let's see. Look, Jamie Yamaha.
No.
Sure, you can help him.
Yeah. Throw it in the junk and get a Harley.
Let's see. Okay, so this guy's into mechanics. Now, if I'm a mechanic are looking for somebody who's into, you know, motorcycles and beer. Looks like he likes beer. Cool. Here's a prospect. This is somebody you probably vibe with, right? So, you know, these are just ways to find people. This is just searching my location. If I'm looking, maybe I own a body shop. Maybe I own, you know, a DIY shop. This would be a good prospect. Let's search. Jamie, what's your city?
Rushville, Illinois.
Rushville?
Yep.
Well, you got hashtags going on. Excuse me. All right. Boots. All right. Let's see. You can keep scrolling. Bathroom selfies. Oh, it always makes me laugh. Let's see. What's this?
So I don't know any of that people. So.
Well, probably not. I'm not suggesting that you find somebody you know. Here we go. Here's the business. So, let's see. Never doubt your gear. Sports outdoors.
Wow, I never heard of them.
This is somebody who's looking to sell outdoors equipment, hiking equipment, sporting goods, basically like a smaller version of Academy. What's this? Hunting. You know, these are ways to find people with common interests. Somebody's growing bean sprouts, it looks like. What's this? Okay, so photography. Check this out. Somebody who got some really cool shots. So this is somebody who's basically in the entrepreneurial space because of what they do. I mean, she's a freelance photographer. This is somebody who could be potentially interested in growing her business, which of course My Lead System Pro could help her do.
Right.
Anyway, that's just another way to find people. Where's the screen share button thing?
That's a lot of good information, Linda. I can't think of any other questions. You know, I just got to put in the work is all it is, you know?
Yeah, and like I said, I mean, there's tons of automated spaces where you can get some of this legwork out for you. I would recommend trying it out for like a week just to at least get the feel of it and see who you really want to target, you know, when it comes to like an automatic following and unfollowing. Obviously, you don't want to follow somebody who's not going to have a bunch of followers that are going to vibe with you. And you're going to unfollow them anyway, so I wouldn't worry about investing too much time. Say hello.
Hello.
Yeah, you're going to unfollow them anyway. Again, that's just to keep expanding your following. It's business. It's not personal. It's just, you need to... Ma'am, you are loud. Look, I'm going to show you what she wants right now.
Of course you want unfollowers. You know, unfollow people because, like you said, you don't want to be marketed to everybody. You don't want everybody on your list. And you don't want everybody following you back. You want to target who you want to work with. So.
Right.
It's safe. I know. Pretty much the same thing with blogging. I mean, you're targeted to a specific group of people that you want to attract attention to. So you blog to their what's the word for it?
Interest.
Interest, yeah.
It's exactly like that. And I figured the reference of like using hashtags as keywords would make more sense to you.
Yeah. I think that's where I was stuck because I was using top tags, you know, and they have like follow for follower, but I didn't know you could search hashtags like that, you know, and that helps me out a lot, you know, so I don't have to use all these pre-written tags.
You know, because, yeah, and like, I mean, you can use, I want to say it's up to like 30 hashtags. I think it may be a character number. I don't know. But I mean, if you stick around between 15 and 25 hashtags, you could potentially just like have a copy and paste that you use that works for your market mm-hmm. once you figure out what's best for your niche. Like a lot of people like in health and wellness like to say health and wealth. So I would hashtag those separately because they're both really ranking.
I got a question. I was using Crowdfire to follow and unfollow people. But it keeps, when I first set it up, I put it up as for Twitter. Well, I've got Instagram on here too. Can I disconnect the Twitter and just use it for Instagram?
To follow I think so. I'm pretty sure you can. I mean, does it allow you to target the people you're following?
It just shows you recent fans, recent unfollowers, recent followers, inactive followers.
How does it follow new people for you?
People that follow you, it tells you if you're following them or not. If somebody unfollows you, it tells you. Like I got 21 unfollows today on Twitter, which Twitter's the same way. I mean, you don't want there's so many people on it and Twitter, and most of them are NMLSP, and their direct message is, hey, check out this Twitter training that you can get for free. My instant message, I got a direct message on Twitter. It's like, if you like my content, contact me on Facebook.
Yeah.
You know, because I'm not going to send all these stupid direct messages.
You know, I don't even mess with Twitter right now. It's a little saturated in my book. I had somebody trying to tell me that it was not saturated, and I'm like, yes, it is.
Yeah. And mine's set up, but when I post something to my page, it automatically posts it to my Twitter.
Yeah.
That's the extent of my Twitter use. But I got a lot of followers. I mean, I went through the Twitter training when I first started in MLSP and set it all up. And I went from like 200 followers. And let's see what I'm at right at the moment. I had like 100, maybe 150 followers. Let's see. I'm at 1,734 or 1,700 followers right now.
Nice.
You know, and I that's all just from posting my Facebook fan page because I don't post any other time to Twitter at all.
Yeah. See, I don't mess with Twitter. The only time that, I mean, I post on there maybe like two or three times a week, and it really doesn't get me a lot of steam. It gets me like one or two followers because I'm not consistent with it.
I take that back. YouTube too. Every time I upload a YouTube video, it automatically posts. So I got two of them posting to Twitter automatically. But
yeah, it was Twitter is just. I think the only time I post to Twitter is like two or three times a week, where I just post something kind of randomly, and then. My blog gets automatically posted to there on YouTube. I have those linked up, but that's it. I just like the engagement that I get. Like when I do an Instagram live, I get people popping in and on all the time. And it's easy because I'm like, hey, where you at? Where you from? Post it in the comments. You know, tell me what you're doing. If you're a small business owner, I'd love to help. I'm a marketing consultant. Ask me now because it's free. You know, stuff like that that gets their attention.
Right.
No, you can't put it here. Put it on that one. She's so mad at me. Attitude, nothing but. I guess that's a girl for you.
Well, I don't have any more questions, but I don't see anybody in the chat that has any questions. I appreciate you coming on short notice and filling in for Terry. Terry had her monthly meeting tonight.
No problem.
And, you know, I always like hanging out with you because you're a wealth of information. So
I certainly try instead of like untap it out of there.
Yeah, I think tonight would be a good night to cover Instagram. And it seems like after Wednesday night, last night, the Facebook Live is going nuts. You know,
yeah, everybody's going nuts over Facebook Live right now and OBS. And I'm like, I can't even use OBS because I have a Chromebook and it's not compatible.
You know, it's funny. I've had OBS installed on my computer for about 6 months, and I've used it off and on. And, you know, it sucks. I do.
Does it?
I can't get OBS to work right. So I went and found a different one that works. It's called XSplit Broadcaster. And not only does it work better, but in my opinion, it works better, but I can also either broadcast to my Facebook fan page or I can broadcast to YouTube Live. Either way. You know, so there's a lot of OBS. I just never could get it to work on my computer. I don't know what the deal is with it, but I even went and downloaded the latest one, and when they had the last Facebook Live training, it still wouldn't work right. So I didn't even go to last night's training. I was working on my course.
But yeah, it was neat to see some of the stuff, but I tapped out after like 45 minutes. I wasn't feeling well, and I was like, I can't even use OBS on my Google Chromebook, so I'm just not even going to mess with it right now.
I worked on my course last night and got it all moved over to my pennypinchermarketing.com, which is what this is on.
Yeah.
Then because I'm getting ready to wipe out my blog and start all over with the Divi team, so I want as less content as possible on there. And I know I won't get anything done tomorrow night because tomorrow's my daughter's 21st birthday. And that's my baby. So we promised to take her out to eat and stuff like that tomorrow night. So
that's exciting.
Yep. And I had it all clicked on you. So you were sure. That's why nobody was seeing me.
Oh.
But I want to change this blog over, you know, and something I found, which many posted in our group about blogging communities. I went and joined some blogging communities and joined some communities on the Divi theme. And these guys are wanting to make money blogging stuff, but they have no product to sell, or the product they're selling is like $10. It's like, come on, people, get some real products to sell. If you're going to blog for money, you got to sell some real products.
For real?
I mean, I posted a little spiel on one of them and put my blog link in there and said, you know, check it out. I'm getting ready to revise or revamp my blog for using the Divi theme. Any suggestions would help. You know, I got 3 leads out of that just by posting one time in that group, and I was brand new to that group.
Nice. See, I need to find groups for me because I haven't posted in the work from home group, but they're so oversaturated. Everybody's in there, and I'm like,
yeah, ever since I taught posting in groups, everybody's posting in them groups. So,
yep.
So I'm the same way. I'm looking for new groups that are untapped.
But hey, it makes you a better marketer, right? When you have to find a new resource.
Yeah. I mean, and that's what people don't understand. I mean, they're all looking for MLM and make money from home and work from home and affiliate marketing and internet marketing, you know. I'm not going to say what I'm thinking because you're probably thinking the same thing. That little secret hidden for a little while. Big thing I've been working on, and I've been working with Dave on this, is attraction marketing, because I got into attraction marketing intensive, you know. And I don't think you were there Saturday night. I don't remember if you were or not. But I taught a little formula on how to do videos for any product. And
yeah, I was there, remember?
Oh,
ever since I started using sarcasm.
Oh, yeah, that I remember now. Yeah. I've had a hell of a week. Our engineer started the subdivision I've been working on for almost a year. The first thing you got to do when you're going to build a subdivision establish the boundary of the subdivision. Well, I've been designing this whole subdivision with a shit boundary. And the plans are due tomorrow. And another engineer that can draw, and another senior technician. I'm a senior technician. So basically you got an engineer, two senior technicians, and a project engineer working on this, redesigning this to hold a subdivision. Why the project manager sitting around going, "Oh, I wish we'd hurry up and get the plans done." We redesigned this whole subdivision, and we started on Monday, and we're going to be real close to having the plans done tomorrow.
Dang. That's crazy.
It's an 85 lot subdivision. So, you know, you've got sanitary sewer, you got storm sewer, you got water, you know, plus all the lots. I had to redo the lots, and then I got to checking roads and stuff. They went into designing the sanitary and the water main, and I got to checking the lots. Well, some of the lots still weren't the correct bearing because the way you do it, you offset from a boundary line, north and south boundary line, offset your roads.
Right.
Everything's parallel, and then your other roads, you east-west line, you offset them, and then you build your lots off them roads and stuff, so that way all your lines are parallel because you're offset.
Right. So everything's based on that boundary line, and of course everything was messed up.
Everything was messed up. You know, I redesigned it once, and I had to go in and fix about 30 lots, you know, because they weren't parallel, and I had to fix three roads that I thought I had parallel, and they weren't. So. But, you know, it took me 2 days to redesign all the lots and the whole subdivision. And, you know, it's taken the rest of us to redo this. I've been working on the sanitary sewer and the profiles. And
that's all AutoCAD, right? Like,
well, usually I use MicroStation GeoPack. That's where, because I'm used to doing highway. I'm with a state DOT work for a while. So I've been using AutoCAD Civil 3D for this subdivision. That's what's funny about it.
Stop.
As I've used, but MicroStation and GeoPack for 2 years, all I've done is highway design and local roads and interstate highways for the last 10-12 years. And so I had to reteach myself AutoCAD Civil 3D because my degree's in AutoCAD, but I haven't used it in 10, 12 years. But it's the top of the hour, and I'm sure everybody, I want to respect everybody's time. I didn't see any questions in the comments. Like, Joe and Barb and Katie and whoever else is in the chat that didn't log in. And I thank you very much, WonderWhit, for coming and hanging out with me and teaching me this Instagram. And I'm sure everybody got a lot of value out of it. So, see, tomorrow is Friday. So, Pastor Jackie will have her live show around between 12:30 and 1 o'clock at PastorJackie.com. And then, of course, Saturday we have our hangout again. And I know Dave's going to be teaching some stuff on videos that I've taught him out of the Attraction Marketing Intensive, so I'm sure he'll be teaching on that. And Monday night, it'll be 24-hour marketing mastermind, me and K-Stage and Dave Renica and Pops all back together, because Katie and Pops have been gone because they had a death in the family, you know, and our condolences go out to them. And then Tuesday at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time is Marketing Systems at Work, I think is the name of it. So with Maria and Sonia Harris. I had to think for a minute. And Tuesday, what's good?
That's Tuesday is our team hangout.
And then Wednesday is, you have your team hangout. And then Wednesday is Wisdom Wednesday with Pat Patterson. I only showed up Tuesday night because I wanted to see what was going on. They kept tagging me in it.
Yeah, it's fun. It's more of a hangout than anything. I don't think anybody's had any real, like, questions lately, so it's just kind of, like, talking for a little bit, and you know how Pat goes on his stories, so.
Yeah. And then Thursday night, come back here to the Jamie Shaw Marketing Show, and we'll have some new topic for you next week. But that's it for this week. We'll see y'all later.
Bye.